by the New Mexico Broadcasters Association.
An Albuquerque attorney says his client is a sacrificial lamb. Sad Bregman represents former officer Gil Vigil, who was fired from APD yesterday. Vigil was one of two officers who went to Omari Varela's house in June, 6 months before his mother was charged with beating him to death. The department says neither followed standard procedure, and now Vigil is out of a job. KOAT Action 7 News anchor Royal Day has more.
Attorney Sam Bregman says this whole thing is ludicrous. A termination letter was given to former officer Gil Vigil Wednesday morning. Bregman says this is the chief's attempt to appease the community's outrage over this little boy's death.
This is a classic example of a police chief overreacting, feeling pressure, and doing something that is completely ill-advised.
Sam Bregman represents former Albuquerque police officer Gil Vigil. Police lapel cam shows Vigil and officer Scott McMurrow responding to Omari Varela's home last June. A dispatcher told those officers she heard a child being brutally, verbally abused on an open 911 call and advised them to listen to it.
You make everybody sick around you, Omari, everybody.
But they didn't listen to that 911 call. The officers did hear Omari's stepdad talk about his relationship with Omari's mother and her children.
These are all my stepkids. It's just because they don't listen, and I was just stressed out. I was just having a bad day, and I just told her, I said, God, I told her, why did you have so many kids? Because me and her have been off and on throughout the years.
When he went to prison, I was still married to him, and I got pregnant by somebody else.
So the officers knew that the stepdad had been in prison. You later hear Officer Vigil wrap up the visit.
You guys, you seem like good family, decent family. Just be careful.
Okay.
On what you guys say when you say stuff like that.
Right.
You know, I'm gonna overlook it right now.
Target 7 broke the story of this 911 call for help. In February, APD top brass told KOAT the officers made multiple mistakes, like not listening to the 911 call, not filing a report, not contacting Child Protective Services, and spending only 15 minutes at the home when they were logged out on the call for nearly 2 hours. Now, Vigil is terminated. We asked Bregman what his client, Officer Gil Vigil, and Officer Scott McMurrow did for the hour and 45 minutes they were logged out on the Omari call, but were only at the home for 15 minutes.
I don't know the specifics of exactly how long he was there, but Officer Vigil absolutely believes that he did a thorough investigation.
The officers apparently never pulled Omari aside, away from the adults, to see what the child would say. The officers never called CYFD, and they did not check Omari for physical abuse.
Him and his fellow officer would never leave there or not arrest somebody if they thought child abuse had taken place, but they didn't believe it had.
There were two officers there that day. Officer Vigil is the only one to get this termination letter. Officer McMurrow is still under investigation.
Bregman says if former officer Gil Vigil were suspended or reprimanded by APD, Bregman could accept that, but he believes his client should not be fired.
Bregman has filed an appeal to that termination. A hearing officer will be appointed to the case. Today, Governor